Hello, and welcome back to Steven's Sausage Roll. I was sick for quite a while. I had a stomach bug. So, sorry for not telling you guys about that sooner. I mentioned it in a YouTube comments section and in the Drawn forums, and I think maybe one other place, but I was really out of it, and I just, was not in any shape to do any recording. And, I sure could have figured out some way to tell all you guys sooner about that, but it's alright, it's all good. You know, it's important to take time off to attend to your own health, for sure. But, in any case, I'm back in good shape, and we're back to actually take a look at this, puzzle again. Not this one. I already know, how to solve you. Hold on. This is the state where I already solved Apex. Interesting. So it didn't actually reload from, the state I reloaded from earlier. I guess it just kept this one, and then, when I reloaded this one, I didn't make any progress, so I guess this one's still, like, my current most progress thing. So it just loaded this instead of this, I guess. We'll see what happens when I create an alternate timeline, but, that might be interesting to take a look at. Right, so as I was saying, your health, it's very, very important, and, it's something I've grown to appreciate a whole lot more as I've grown older. It's just something you really take for granted a lot of the time, because so many of the things that you do to take care of yourself, your preventative measures, are things that seem really pointless at the time, but they pay off in really invisible ways. And that's something that we as humans kind of have a hard time doing, is doing things that really help us in invisible ways. But I guess that's kind of what puzzle games are all about, is having some concrete goal in the future that you want to work towards, and you're not quite sure how you want to get it done. And often there are perfectly logical steps that you can take, and oftentimes with really simple problems, it is obvious and logical how these things connect to one another, and there's an obvious mechanism of influence. But sometimes you get a puzzle like this one where your connection isn't quite so, doesn't quite make as much sense. Oh, I guess at this point the analogy kind of breaks down, because especially in a puzzle game like this one, where everything's grid-based and everything's kind of discrete, like, it still makes sense what the solution is going to be afterwards. Like, when I solve this puzzle, I'm going to be confident that I know what the solution is, I'm sure. And it might be something specific, it might even be unsatisfying, who knows, but at the very least, I will know what makes the difference between a solution and not a solution. Whereas, with matters of health and medicine, it's, a lot less clear. I'll just put it at that and leave it at that, I guess. Right, so it's been a while. Almost a week. Not quite, but almost a week. So there were lots of avenues I was exploring, but most of them at least started with this. Or, in fact, some of them even started with this. That was alright, too. But I think the most promising avenue of exploration just started with sliding the whole dam over. At least because, A, that gives me more tools to work with on the other side of this whole thing, and, more angles to explore, and B, it seemed like the strategy I ran into thus far with the smallest number of steps in between, like, where I was now, and a potential solution that might solve the whole puzzle. So let's see, last time we had the issue that, right, the issue we were running into was that when I hung this thing off the east edge, like so, and I dropped it down there, that does recreate, well, eventually, ultimately, a bridge for me. But right now, as things stand, because this is already in here, in the way, I can't slide that underneath it. So when that is placed on the west, I put this out over there, then we wind up with the problem that we noticed earlier, where essentially, the problem is that this gets propped up against the west side here. And technically that wouldn't happen if this were a horizontal sausage, in which case it would already be dunked in the river, or B, if there were some way of remotely pushing this south, in which case it would just be out of the way, and I could log roll that all the way west and continue. But there was a similar problem that was brought across that, which, like, even if I do manage to get that done, then how do I, continue? And I think the continuation process involved some kind of, swapping. So, let's even just, like, pretend that I got all that done. Sometimes that's a useful thing to do, is just, when you want to experiment with the back half of a solution, but you're not sure how to do that, in some cases it's possible to pretend that you've solved the front half of something, then work as though you'd solve the front half of that, and then see if you run into any contradictions in the back half of your solution, and see if that, like, invalidates your front half somehow. That can be useful for ruling out lines of inquiry, too. So let's assume that, like, say, this center sausage is already cooked. From that situation, can I solve the puzzle? And if so, like, A, is there an easy way to do that that, like, relies on this being already cooked? And B, is do I, like, automatically run into any problems? And sometimes during the course of those investigations, you actually do run into an easy way of fixing your original problem anyway, just because you're thinking a different way. Even if you're not necessarily doing anything necessarily super different, just the fact that you're thinking along different modes can at least lead you to notice things you didn't notice earlier. And that's what's really going to be key in this puzzle, is there's just some tiny detail that I'm just not noticing. And that's, and whether that detail is something geographical, or something about the shape of, the dam, or just something about the sausages, I'm not sure. I already examined my starting conditions earlier. There wasn't much I could do to change that. Well, okay, there was one thing. The one thing that I can do is that I don't have to start in the middle like this. That is true. I did try starting on, like, on the east side and on the west side, and I kind of just straight up gave up on them soon. But in principle, there's no particular reason why this shouldn't work. Like, this winds up being about the same thing as if I had manually done all this stuff at the beginning, and then extracted the sausage out the middle. But it, yeah, so, like, it's not hard to just dump this on this level. I guess I'll call this ground level, for lack of a better term. And if I'd done the separation step I've done several times, and I dumped this out on the ground, that's basically the same state as what I've got now. So I can choose to start the puzzle there if I want to start the puzzle there, but that kind of seemingly implies that I don't want to, because the other one is easier to start in and hard to get to later, if that makes any sense. Anyway. Right, so that leaves the problem of elevation, which was the other thing I was trying to get at once I, you know, uncompress the stack and talk about all my other topics, is, kind of lacking in ways to do that. I can do that if I make certain, make certain changes. Like, if I embed this in the dam, excuse me, at some point, then I can lift that along with the dam. Or if I make one of these sausages horizontal, which is kind of hard and kind of dependent upon having one lifted up there already, then I can later on lift that up again, and then drop it, and then rotate it again. So that's a way of taking, like, a leftover horizontal sausage from some earlier phase of the solution, and then writing it into vertical again. Yeah, I mean, I guess this works. That is a move that will work. I think I've done something similar with some of the floating islands earlier. So what does this imply? Like, we've already seen earlier that if you stand on top of a sausage, and you make, I don't know, if, for example, this move were blocked somehow by a sufficiently tall pole, which we certainly don't have in this puzzle, but I'm still just thinking along those lines. If you're standing on top of a sausage, you don't move in the same way that you do if you're standing atop of free-moving terrain. That was the lesson we learned in Apex. So that kind of cuts out certain methods of locomotion of this, of this dam in the first place. Yeah, so we can do all the work we want at this level. We can do almost whatever we want. Not quite whatever we want, but almost whatever we want, because whenever we're done, we can do this and then bring it back and then, like, turn this into the other solution that we wanted. So at any time, we can change our mind, go back, do that, and then do North Island work if we want to. So this is one way of bridging the gap. The other one is the dam. Those are the only two tools we've seen so far in order to, do this sort of thing. I guess this makes sense. Yeah, I was carrying it on top of my head. I was carrying the sausage on top of my head, but I don't really have any way of rotating this, because it's kind of just in the way. I'm beginning to wonder if there's some way that... Alright, this is going to sound really cheesy for a moment, but I was wondering if there's any way of putting this this bit of movable terrain on top of a sausage, and I put the sausage on top of my head. I wonder if then what happens if I put the sausage on top of my head and I rotate. Like, the rule that a sausage on top of my head rotates implies that the sausage on top of my head would turn 90 degrees when I turn 90 degrees. The rule that, terrain on top of my head does not rotate if I rotate 90 degrees would imply that, it's not gonna rotate. Sausages don't rotate when they're held up by anything else that rotates. Like, for example, if my fork rotates like this, it's not the pivoting point. So if I have a sausage on top of my head, it just falls. It doesn't rotate along with my fork. If I, I can't rotate the sausage if the sausage is inside my fork. That's not a thing that happens in this game. And if there's terrain on top of my fork, then it won't rotate either. So if I have a stack on top of my head, like me at the bottom, sausage in the middle, terrain on top of me, then what happens if I rotate? My initial guess is that the sausage will rotate, but the terrain will not. And the terrain will just move according to, like, the rules of whatever the sausage rotating will push. Like, we've seen that earlier, where the sausage rotating can kind of act almost like my fork in certain ways as far as pushing things is concerned. Where, say, if it's facing south and it rotates to face west, it'll first push west when it goes to the diagonal, and then north when it goes to the westward side, in much the same way that a rotating fork would. And I assume it'll do exactly the same thing for terrain and all the ways that my fork would. But I don't think if there's any, like, there's no interactions like that. Otherwise, I think a piece of terrain on top of the sausage that is not otherwise interacted with, I think that will probably just stay still. I don't think that will rotate. That's all a guess, though. I don't know if there's going to be any easy way of testing that in this puzzle, but it's just something I'm thinking about. In any case, I'm not sure to what extent that would actually help in this puzzle, though. Most of the really useful things this this piece of terrain does is when you sink it down by a level and have it hanging off of something. Although, my mind is already at work trying to figure out if that could somehow apply to this channel over here. But nevertheless, depending upon the way I rotated it, that would either block the ladder, or the ladder would be facing out to sea, and I wouldn't be able to use it. And otherwise, if it's, like, facing east, like, I guess the ladder's facing east, and it's over here, there's just not much to hang off of. So I don't think rotating this dam, I don't think rotating this would even serve much of a purpose, even if I could do it. But it's fun to think about. Okay, so with that level of, philosophizing out of the way, I suppose it's time we get down to a little bit more business, at least a little bit more experimentation. So last time we thought that it might be helpful to, like, take the, tab in this little, thing, like, this thing, and, push it out to the other side, and then we ran into other complications that kind of arose because of that, if I remember right. Chief among them being that you can't lower the dam into... like, all the way into the channel to the same depth that you can when it's facing south, because it'll get hung up on the north island. So it'll be kind of upraised by one level, and then you kind of wind up having to use this as a bridge anyway. So interestingly, we can actually just do this straight away, if we just want to dump that on the island and get both of our sausages back. Like, if we just want to get both of these back immediately and leave that up there, that is a thing I can do. I don't know why I would want to do that, but that is a thing I can do. In fact, I can even separate the sausages like that and then individually bring them back, and that's also fine. But that kind of leaves me without a way of elevating them, unless I bring the dam back. Whoops. Alright, given that I'm apparently playing around with, sausage in the middle more than sausage at the east, I think I'd better just make sure I officially change my starting conditions. Just to make everything official. I don't suppose starting at the west has some hidden value that I haven't really seen before yet. No. No, I think it's just going to be badly positioned. Yeah, I don't think that's going to help much. So, that'll save me some effort every time I want to restart the puzzle, which hopefully won't be too much more times, but we'll see. We'll see. Yeah, I'm sure I'll look back at this and laugh. That's how it goes. But that's okay. That's part of the joy of puzzle making, and especially the joy of, puzzle making on video, or puzzle solving, I should say. Although puzzle making to a lesser extent as well. I hope to do that at some point, too. I really want to make some videos of drawn architecture, but I just haven't really had the opportunity to just line up real well yet. I'll get my chance, though. One of these days. Right, so as before, there is no meaning to doing any of this unless I cook this sausage at some point, so I might as well at least do that while I'm proposing hypotheses. Except we don't go that far. No, we go one fewer over. That's right. Yep, so that works. Then we do this. Then we ran into the problem of how do you insert this back in here and still get all the work done that you want. Which we kinda came to the conclusion that you can't, mostly. Because essentially, yeah, there's no horizontal dismount at this point unless you clog everything up. And you can't clog everything up? Is that what I decided on? Yeah, you can't clog everything up. Right? Interestingly, it's not sunk yet. Yeah, it's not sunk yet if I do that. So, for example, we do this and it winds up being about the same thing as if I pre-placed that there. So it's not really that interesting. But does this result in this? No, of course not. It, that sausage is still in the way. For multiple reasons. So we need to find some way of elevating this thing. And essentially getting it around this. Right, so that was what led me to the other avenue of exploration, which I guess I'll just review again real quick. It never hurts to go back over these things. It takes time, for sure, but it doesn't hurt, usually. Right, so I could put that all the way over, or not even that far over. I don't really need that much space. I could just go here, for example. I need to go a certain minimal amount over, but it's not real far. So, for example, I could do this to give me a little bit of leverage in between the cliff here. And it was just a matter of figuring out how to drop this by exactly one. Here's an idea that I haven't really played around with much. I could put this over here. And the reason why this is special is it's not real far off. So for example, I could do this. and then put this back over there. Now, what has that done for me? That's actually solved the puzzle for me, I think. I think that's actually solved the puzzle for me. Yeah, because with that, I can put that over there, and now I can slide this out like I noticed earlier, and now I can dump that off the cliff, and we've done this. We can climb back over, and we can make use of all those observations we made over the course of all those long, arduous episodes. And now we're essentially back to the start, I think. Because what I do is I move this over here. I basically just use this as temporary holding spot. Does that fix everything, though? I mean, we're good. I'm still happy I did all this. But, like, the fact that I've done all of this now is... well, hold on. No. It's fine. Because I can still get back to the... I want to raise the uncooked one now, of course. But what I do is I just do the rotation here, and it's going to be like a three-point rotation. And I can use this cliff over here to do that. So now, the uncooked one is in the center, and I can use the cooked one to be, well, the bridge, really. How do I move that over exactly one again? Well, I can just leave that over there. Yeah, leave that over there. Now you go over only one. You were already going to do that because of the sausage, so never mind that then. Everything's fine. Nothing to worry about. Yeah, you go over here. And now we lift. Hold up. Lift this, go back. Lift it again, go over here. And rinse and repeat. So, there was one key insight I was missing, and that key insight was extremely subtle, but it's a different flavor of an insight I already made. And it was related to a lot of other geometric insights I noticed, but the consequences of that were far from obvious, I'm sure you'll agree. And that was that you could place this on this far side of the shore, it's far now because I'm on the north side, and it would still be within two tiles of the other coast. So that's a different way of saying that the channel is only one wide. But it meant that I could make a move that I thought was impossible, that I thought would be a problem, but actually wasn't. And that's actually been a recurring theme in this puzzle game, is making moves you thought were impossible, but actually weren't. And those seemingly impossible moves, once you have the courage to make them and decide not to restart the puzzle... And, like, actually really, really decide, like, what are the consequences of this seemingly impossible move that might throw away the puzzle or might not. If I decide that the puzzle is not, like, if I haven't ruined it yet, what can I do with this? And it turns out the answer is it's not impossible and you can solve the puzzle. And that was one flavor of basically pushing this dam off, like, off the edge. You have to have the courage to push the dam off the edge... to a spot where you think it's irretrievable, but it's not, because you're going backwards towards a screen, and using the 2x1 sausage in order to retrieve it off. So there's nothing like mechanically difficult about that. We've been doing stuff like this since World 3, which, oh gosh, World 3 seems like it was an eternity ago, but it's the same thing. It's the same thing, just posed differently. There's an old saying among grandmasters, chess grandmasters, that the backwards moves are the hardest ones to spot. And why should that be? They're not any different than other moves, but, like, you want to be aggressive in chess. You often want to move your pieces, like, off towards the other opponent. Let me try and solve the puzzle while I'm talking here, although that might be a little bit difficult. I'll do my best, though. Right, so your instinct is to go towards the enemy king, or to, otherwise, like try and move forward. And, you're also, like, in chess, you're sitting at a side of a table, so the chessboard is in front of you. So you kind of naturally, because of the setting, you kind of, like, see the pieces moving away from yourself. Not just in the opening, obviously, when you're, like, moving the pawns forward and you're moving your knights outward and all that. You're also, right. So you... Right, so you do this. Right, you dump this on the other side, so you put it on the sausage. So you get out of the way just for the time being. Up there, that's fine. Right, so sometimes a backwards move, oftentimes in the middle game, is the perfect move that, like not only, like, defends and attacks at the same time, but otherwise, like, gains you time instead of losing you time, or something like that. Or, anyway, it's just often harder to think of these things, like, quickly than it is to, right, that's the wrong order of events. So you don't poke that out first. You bring it back first. And now it's hanging off of the cliff, and then you poke that out. Or not. Wait, how did this work again? I think you... No. So you rotate that all the way through. And then this is only held up by that, and... Oh, wait, no. You need the bottom to not be able to move for some reason or another. So you do, this. And then you have to be able to bring it back. Wait, that's not right. I mean, if I want, I could just check over the undo history and figure out how I did this the first time, but... I should be able to figure this out. Oh, right. Right, you hang it... Yeah, I was able to... I already did the hangover. Not the hangover. The transfer of the sausage... I swapped the ground-level sausage and the dam around each other. But the reason this works now is because the dam is being held up by this cliff. So it can't move. That's why that works that way. Okay. So then I do that. Then I walk over... Got both of my sausages cooked. Life is good. Anyway, where was I? Right. So the backwards move is not instinctual. And that's, like, that's what I'm trying to tie into here. The backwards move is kind of, the backwards dimension, even, is, like, a kind of a blind spot in general, because it's, moving things back towards yourself, like, seems like backwards progress. There's, like, a really primitive, notion associated with that. And, it can be hard to overcome that sometimes. And also, it's, like, the area of three-dimensional, like, reasoning that it's also a little bit harder to work with, because we're so used to measuring distances in relation to either things that are far away, or, like, if things are close to us, we measure, like, the distance from us to them. That's, like, a really, primal sort of thing. It's, like, radiating that measuring stick outwards from us onto the incoming object, rather than from the incoming object to us. So when you're working with that close field stuff, when you're trying to measure a distance not from the object to you, or I guess to the camera, but from the object that is coming closer to you to another thing that is closer to you, then that's the sort of thing that if it's not, like, academic, or if it's not, like, something, like, really, like, like really coldly phrased, like if you phrase in terms of, like, train schedules or something, if you're talking about it in the phrase of, like, some kind of island here, like with sausages on it, it can be a little bit harder to overcome. At least this is the impression I get from being an armchair psychologist who's only read papers and has never done a lot of, like, formal study of this kind of thing. Maybe I'm making all of this up. If you have comments about this kind of thing, I'd actually love to hear them. This is exactly what I'm trying to philosophize a little bit more, just to give people some more stuff to talk about, other than, oh wow, you really did solve that puzzle today. Good job. Which, is good. I appreciate that, and in fact, I, like, left a comment about that just the other day, because I think it's important to encourage that kind of positivity. But at the same time, it is exactly the kind of comment that's hard to make, so... I'll try and see if I can give you guys a little bit more fodder to work off of here. In any case, I'm going to solve this puzzle again, and then I'll be right back. Alright, I just had a quick look around, and... Actually, wait a second. Steven, you fool, what have you done? You ate your, you ate the last sausages. You ate both of the sausages in Ancient Dam. Last time, I only figured out how to solve Apex with two sausages. Now we only have the one. How am I gonna get this done with only one? I guess that's worth a try. Not like I really have anything better to do at the moment, because if I go back, then I run into the other problem where I'd have to solve Ancient Dam with one sausage, and, you know, that doesn't seem super appealing right now. You know, just on a personal level. So, I think of the two, this one is more likely to be solvable with just the one sausage than the other one. So, I'm willing to look back at this one again and rethink a few assumptions, if that would help. Because I do know how to solve this with two sausages, and I know what the method is, the methodology that helps. So, maybe I can adapt that to work with one. Who knows? In any case, I certainly didn't have any trouble making it down to the bottom, but, this new revelation certainly does make me think a little bit about the relationship between these two, puzzles. Maybe it's not so, unintentional after all that you're, allowed to, make it to this puzzle first of all. Although sneaking a sausage in here, seems a little bit, still seems a little bit unintentional, but... I don't know. I'm not really sure what to think anymore, actually. But in any case, we have to work with what we've got, what we're given, the cards we're dealt, all those other warm and loving cliches. So, it's definitely no accident, then, therefore, that both of them are accessible at the start. Because if this thing is solvable with one sausage, then an unassuming player who just walked up to this thing and didn't do the thing I did where I was able to sneak a sausage into this puzzle, would therefore be able to solve it. At least is what I'm thinking here. If this thing is solvable with one sausage, which I'm not ready to render judgment on that quite yet, but the game is giving me incentive to think again on that matter. I thought the case might be closed, but, in fact it wasn't. There was a piece of key evidence that I, did not have, which was the... whether or not, solving Ancient Dam, would unlock any green sausages, and, I don't think it did. No, I don't believe it did. No. No, Steven, I'm pretty sure Steven only ate two sausages. I'll look over the footage in between episodes if I really have to, but I'm pretty sure it didn't. Like, I don't want to question myself too much here. I'm a decent individual. I can remember things occasionally, when they're relevant. Remind me again how this thing works. Right. I do this move, and then it's okay that it's on my head, because I can scrape it off like so. So, the reason... part of the reason an additional sausage helped me out here, part of the reason that that worked, was that it was an additional pushing implement... well, the reason was that I could have a sausage both in front of and behind this thing. So, A, I could have a bridge here that I could use in order to transport the ladder away from the cliff. So that when I dumped it off the cliff, it wouldn't be, directly adjacent to the, like, it wouldn't be directly adjacent to the cliff, which, as we've seen, is problematic. And, B, I was able to use the other sausage to have one in front of me that I could basically just wind up using as another, bridge off of the second cliff. So, is there therefore perhaps some way of swapping this thing around so it can perform both roles? Maybe. As we've seen, the placing this sausage, like pushing it downwards, for example, from this position. Let me back up a little bit, actually. This will help a little bit. Just leave that over there. Yeah. So as we saw the other time, pushing this downwards like this was helpful in and, well, a little bit. Yeah, that one didn't end up winding going anywhere. We just didn't really have anywhere to put it in particular. But when I did this series of moves, well, it was helpful because it was already supported by something. It didn't fall on the grills. But it was helpful to have something else to push this over. Like, we wound up pushing this over top of, well, the ladder. We had something to support it on so that it wound up making it over this little gap here and onto that cliff, and that ended up making all the difference in the world. Whereas in this scenario, either the ladder will be there to support it, in which case we kind of run into this problem of not having much to do with this if we do this series of moves. Or the ladder isn't there and it just falls straight down and we have a different problem of how to retrieve it. In any case, if we're going to have only this ladder and only this sausage, and it seems pretty clear that our victory condition has to be somehow getting this sausage on the other side of the ladder. Which is complicated, to say the least. Well, I suppose one thing we could do is start over here, start by shoving this down here, rolling this off the cliff, rolling this off the cliff and seeing if it does us any good. Not really. I think I might have even tried this at some point. It didn't, pretty obviously didn't help. And if we stay over here like this, then basically the main problem of worth working with this thing is that unlike a lot of the other movable terrain that we've had in other puzzles, it's really hard to lift this one. Because to do so implies that, A, it's already elevated to a certain degree off the ground by something. Probably, I don't know, a sausage. You have to get underneath that and then lift the thing that's holding it up, and then you can lift this thing up. Otherwise, all this thing has ever been doing this whole time has been falling down, moving around laterally in the X and Z directions and falling straight down. That's all it's been doing. Sometimes you can move one or maybe even two squares out and off of just one square off of a ledge. And you can move the ledge itself if the ledge happens to be a sausage, like we were doing just now. But otherwise, there's a limited number of ways in which you can kind of gain purchase on this thing. It's pretty straightforward, which is what makes puzzles like this so tough. And the other case, the sausage, there's a limited number of ways you can work with that, too. The only real way I see of actually, getting this around this is to do something like this, where we're temporarily holding it out over the edge. I guess another thing we could do is, instead of stabbing it, we could push it out over that. So, for example, if I haven't yet done this, I can push it to the south like I was examining earlier. Which does work. We've got just barely enough room. So what does this let us do? This lets us do a move I previously dismissed, which is this. Does this help? Doesn't seem to help. I don't think there's much to do beyond this point. I can log roll that over there, but then I don't have anything to do. I don't have anything to dismount off of. And there's not really any meaningful difference between log rolling on this side or on the other half. I mean, while it is endlessly amusing that I can log roll way past what should be the balancing point of center of mass for this thing, center of mass and rotation are not really concepts that exist in this universe, so, they're more for private entertainment value than for any actual kind of practicality purpose, unless the puzzle itself demands it, of course, but this one does not appear to. So in the end, what we're trying to get is the ladder in front of the ladder in front of this thing. And putting it in front like this on like this lower half does not seem especially helpful because I don't have anywhere else to go after that. Like, part of the reason I was so focused on trying to get it, the whole formation, that's the word. Like, one square shifted up to the north, is that there is a convenient dismount point up there in the form of that cliff, and I could use that to then, like, move forward again without log rolling and climb down and get the puzzle done that way. So, it was exactly these kinds of observations that led me to believe that I wanted a second tool, and indeed even carried out the machinations in order to get that second tool. But now a different part of the game is telling me that, hey, you don't actually want that. And this is something that Draw doesn't do very often, or indeed a lot of other puzzle games, which is to set two puzzles in front of you and give you a constraint that is relevant to both of them, which is namely that extra sausage. So in this case, like, the extra sausage has helped me solve either Ancient Dam in the incredibly obvious way, which is to prop up the dam so it doesn't fall in the drink before you even start the puzzle. That's what you need extra sausage for Ancient Dam. Or for this one, which was very subtle in that it helped you solve a puzzle with having extra resources, when the normal resources were proving to not be enough. But so far, everything that I've done seems to imply that perhaps there was a subtle way of solving this with the original set of resources after all. And that only became clear after I had solved both puzzles. And that's, again, that's like, unless you play around with blue doors or scripting or like, potentially state-based mechanisms with green doors and tar and other bits of that stuff in Deadly Rooms of Death, you can't really do that in, like, room-based puzzle games, where so much of the state is tied to the room. As we've seen again, you can tie state to room entrances, and the tools you get available from said entrances. Well, I mean, that's a rich area of study. But in a lot of other, like just individual puzzle games, like, not even like Baba Is You, but I don't know, something like Minesweeper or Black Box or Bridges or, you know, any of those like cute, kitschy little 90s era puzzle games where you just had like one screen puzzle games. You don't really have that kind of feature because, resources are tied to individual puzzles. That's a huge assumption that the puzzle game makes, and it's being subverted here. Very deliberately. Now, I should also note that, from this position, I can make certain moves. Like, I did notice the other time that, like, you can make this move, and provided that sausage isn't there, you can... Whoops. Let's go ahead and undo that restart. I wanted to undo, not restart there, but I guess I, like, canceled out the restart in my mind or something. I don't know. So I should note that I can do this. That is a move I can make. So if I can somehow wind up with a sausage in front of this thing, which might be doable? Maybe. It might be doable. Then there is a certain number of things I can do with that. I don't know what that number is, though. It might be zero. Okay, so maybe it wasn't a very certain number after all, then. Let's see. So let's back up even further, then, to before I put it up there, then. Even further. Go back. Here? Yeah, well, not even that far. Yeah, here. What I could do is... Well, I can't just dump it off now. Because if I dump it off now while I'm riding on this thing, then I have no way down other than to fall down here. And falling down here is not very good either. Yeah, none of that is any good. I don't like any of that. If I instead don't dump that off. Then we run into the other problem of how do I get this around the other thing. So this is why I was also thinking about the other time, about losing my fork. But then you also have to think logically about why would you want to lose your fork. And, I never did actually do that, come to think of it. Like, I think I talked about that, and I think I talked about certain things I might be able to do, and certain things that would still be impossible even if I did do that. But I never actually did it. I never did actually lose my fork in this puzzle. But even then, I'm still having a trouble deciding, just because, I want to do it. If I want to do it, okay. Maybe I should start again from the beginning. What would losing my fork allow me to accomplish in this situation? Specifically with only one sausage. It would mean that I would have a bridge that is not the sausage to push this ladder over. So that later, I could walk over my fork, walk down the ladder. I could build, for example, fork, ladder, sausage. Then it would actually be really easy, wouldn't it? Because then I would walk down the ladder. Let's say I grab my fork. Let's just, while I'm dreaming here. Let's say I lose my fork facing north and I grab my fork. Then that allows me to push the ladder, like I would build fork, ladder, sausage. And sausage would already be on the far side of the ladder. I'd walk over my fork to get to the ladder. Then I'd climb down the ladder, get my fork, push all that. I'd basically push everything west, right? Because then I'd push the sausage off the west edge, the one down there by the tree, first. So then I'd basically be like reversing my stacks, essentially. I'd be putting down the sausage, the last thing I put down here, first. So that would become the first thing on the burners. Then I'd put the ladder on there. And then I'd just get on the sausage, log roll west, and everything would be great. So I guess that's actually a pretty reasonable thing to be doing. I don't know if I could necessarily lose my fork facing north. If I had to guess, it's probably going to be a more inconvenient direction by, west or south or something. But we might as well at least take a look at that. So for that, I will restart. So, that of course brings up the separate question. What elements of this puzzle require the use of my fork? As we've seen, I have ways of pushing this thing around, even if it's in this direction, by using my butt. So, I don't necessarily need my fork to push this block around. It is helpful in certain ways from rescuing it from the edge. Like, for example, if I do this, I can bring it back from the edge with that. That's one of its strongest features. I am not exaggerating here when I say that's one of the most useful things you can do with the fork, above and beyond a lot of the other things you can do with it. Well, I mean, it's kind of unfair to rank its features, but when it comes to just basic day-to-day tactics, I'd say that's one of the most important ones. Although I guess having reach is also important too, but I mean, in a vacuum, in a flat plane with edges, which is nearly everything, that feature certainly shows up a lot. So I can lose my fork on this cliff, but I still need to be able to bring the fork with me. Implicit in this other part of this was the ability to lose my fork and then still bring it with me to use as part of the bridge construction. So that means if I do lose it up here, I have to bring it with me, which is obviously another headache in and of itself. So I think my avenue of investigation might actually just be down here. Before I build the bridge entirely, I think it's going to be in the tree section. So I guess I probably could have just backed up over there, but I wanted to cover my bases up here, so I think it was helpful to do this forwards rather than backwards. So this part, again, rescuing the ladder from this part certainly was a tough feature here that the fork helps with. Not having the fork here would be, I don't want to necessarily say impossible, but certainly a lot more of a pain than this thing is. And it was hard to figure that out in the first place, but at least it was cool. So there's that. Right. So how would we log roll? Well, we know how to do that. First, we turn this horizontal. We know how to do that. We can, in fact, do that. Let's just get this out of, well, off of this, thing. Just like that, I guess. Yeah, sure. So first we do this, then we need, in order to lose your fork, step two is a tall enough cliff. Well, we can obtain one using the fork, I mean using the ladder. If we do this, then it's kind of hard to get back, but I think even this in itself would be enough if I was already on top of the sausage. If I was already on top of the sausage. If I was already top... This section here is also leading me to believe that if I can do this properly, like, I'll be facing north when I do this, so I should be able to lose my fork, in principle. Of course, having another sausage would make this easier, but we'll leave that aside. So it's like I almost want to fall to the ground, don't I? Almost. Well, maybe not quite, but. I don't know, it's gonna be kind of hard. So I need to get on top of a sausage, fall down at least two Y levels. At least two Y levels. So that I wind up with my fork on top of an object. It doesn't even have to be, like, real tall. Like, just a one tall object would do. A one tall object. Like, fall two stories. Find a little tiny one tall, like, nub. To fall onto, to hit my fork, and the fork will be one level raised above me, in the orientation that I was holding it in when I fell. So that's the issue with these gates here. This one up here, three tall. This one down here, two tall. So there's a few other nubs which could potentially substitute for that, but they're also all kind of, eh. So the only, like, way that, like, starts out with all of that is actually the cliff at the start. But that carries its own problem with it. Backing up here for, well... No, actually restarting will be the better way of doing that. So I can restart here, temporarily show this off. So the cliff here is nice, but when I lose my fork up here, then that has the obvious problem of how do I bring it with me. And, that's a question I'm not really sure how to solve, and it doesn't seem like it's particularly productive to try to solve it. So backing up, undoing that restart. Back here... Yeah, there's just kind of a limited number of, like, I guess we'll call them props. Well, not really props, I guess, like, juts, outcroppings, that seem to be good targets for my fork to land on. Things that are kind of taller than usual. And, of course, we have to create that fall as well. And the ladder is the only remaining thing I have that does that sort of thing. So, like, the ladder is the only remaining movable object in the puzzle. Because I didn't bring a sausage in with me. So with the ladder, I can turn a one-tile fall into a two-tile fall. But I have to do it in such a way that I can still retrieve the ladder afterwards, with no fork, mind you, with no fork. And then proceed to, well, basically proceed to assemble all my objects here at the bottom, with no fork. And then build the structure that I was talking about earlier. So... That doesn't seem impossible. It just seems improbable, but it seems at least, like, about as hard as everything else I've had to do in this puzzle game so far. Like, it's a demanding one, for sure. So remind me again why I couldn't do this, like, the cliff itself can be the prop, too, that I've noticed. Like, you don't necessarily need an extra object. Like, just a two tall cliff like this will do. So if I could already be on top of the sausage at this point, and then, and then do all that, then that would be okay. So I guess, for example, what I would do is I'd do something like this. I'd have a ladder I could get on top of. In fact, I could just do this freestanding. I don't even need this Western platform at all. I'd do something like this. Do that. Oh no, I lost my fork. What do I do? I still need some way to actually get off of this thing, but... Like, if I climb that, I'll just get my fork back. Which is actually not what I want. This was predicated on this being a horizontal fall-off. And, yeah, the reason that this worked so well was that this was, like, a little tiny, like, this is a set of two one-tile drops that turned into a two-tile drop. But that still doesn't answer the question of how do I get that ladder off of the, cliff. Because I could probably get the fork off the cliff. I mean, I could get the fork past the ladder, at least. But I don't know how I'd get the fork out of here, out of this row, here. And I don't know how I would get the ladder out of this row here. Both of those without the use of the fork. So that sort of seems to imply that that's the wrong place. So... another potential thing I could do... is if I could figure out how way to, like, place the ladder, like, place the sausage on top of the ladder, and bring that down here. I think I've found ways of doing that. Like, either horizontal or vertical, I think, would work. But somehow figure out a way of, like, being on, like, put the ladder on the ground, the sausage on top of the ladder, and me on top of that. That might be enough to use this, this two-tall gate as a prop. Because then my fork would basically have something to be on top of. Problem is, you need a certain amount of space to do that in, and also you need to somehow elevate yourself to get on top of the sausage, and also be on top of the ladder. Which means you need a way of getting on top of the sausage that is not the blue ladder block. But I could maybe see that working somehow. I don't know how yet, but it would probably involve this somehow, right? But yeah, how would you get on top of the ladder? How would you get on top of that and also still move the bottom piece? I don't know. So it have something to do with this? It might have something to do with this. Because let's see, it's a three-tall gate, so that means that somebody, like, on a moving thing that's on the bottom, you can have a... You can carry something on top of your head through here, but not through here. We've noticed that for the extremely mundane by now use of taking a sausage off the top of our head by passing it, well, through here or through anywhere else, but not passing it through here. This gate's too small. On the other hand, that means if we assemble, like, a stack of objects, like if we put the ladder on top of the sausage and then the sausage on top of our head, if we do that, then start walking around, we're not going to be able to pass through here. Whatever is on the top, whether it's the sausage or the ladder, will get knocked off as soon as I walk through here. If I walk through here, both of them will get knocked off. I was expecting to say a third thing after that, but my mind did not come up with a follow-up to that, so I guess I will not say a third thing after that. Right. I already decided that was a problem. Let's say at least for the time being, back up to before I had a horizontal one here. Horizontal was nice for doing that little tiny log rolling thing, but I don't think it's actually... I don't think that staircase is actually how I'm going to be losing my fork, I think. Especially since it seems to get the ladder into a bad place. I think it's going to have to do with these set of two gates down here instead. So, with that in mind, I think having a vertical sausage, at least for the time being, is going to be better. There may come a point where we want to rotate it anyway, and we'll re-examine at that point, but for the time being now, vertical is going to be better, if only due to the fact that it's going to help me get the ladder down here. For now. Man, we really went a long way for this, though. I mean, half of it was just wandering around, but still. Alright, any day now. Come on. Back it up. When did I decide that turning this thing horizontal was a good idea? Okay, there we go. For a minute there, I was actually wondering if it was stuck in an infinite loop, but I suppose it's not. It was a very finite loopiness that it was stuck in. Okay, so the entire point of this whole exercise was, okay, that answers a question I had, which is that, as I suspected, you can't rotate the ladder like that. You rotate the sausage, but you don't rotate the thing that it's, that's on top of it. Makes sense. You do rotate other sausages, but you don't rotate the ladder. So, we can parade around like this as much as we want. That's, well within our abilities. We can even, perhaps, change the sausage's orientation with respect to ourselves so it's not 90 degrees like this. We might be able to get it into the 180-degree orientation. It's also theoretically possible. Well, I was going to say it might be possible to get the ladder on top of our head and then the sausage on top of that, but I don't know how you would do that. Because as I said earlier, that's gonna be a tall order. I can see how you get the ladder on top of your own head. That one's not hard. You, oh. Well, come to think of it, that might actually be super helpful. Yeah, let's just, put this one aside for now and, just do that. In fact, there might even just be a way to... if I do this just right... you know what? Yeah, sure. Well, no. I was wondering what that tree over there was for. And the tree is useful as a pole, but the tree also has an overhang on it. And you know what overhangs are good for? Getting things on top off the top of your head. So it was that exact realization that led me to believe, hey, if you put the ladder on top of your head, what happens? What would be the consequences of that? And assuming you could do it, which I think there should be a way, if I do this just right. Like, basically I have to make a move that will cause the sausage to move, but this not to. Like, I want to scrape this off the top of it. Also, I don't want this to be horizontal, because it's going to have to be vertical at the end. Because basically what's going to happen is I'm going to log roll, of course, on this vertical sausage with the ladder on top of my head, at the apex, if you will. And because I'm the one log rolling, the ladder is not going to just fall off the front of it like it does every other time I roll the log with the ladder on top of it. Instead, like, it's gonna stay still, because I'm gonna be balancing it on top of my own head, like, you know, circus acts. And, yeah, it's just gonna stay there. And I think what will happen is... Yeah, it'll drop the thing behind me. Because I'll be standing on the log at the end, perched at the tip of the cliff, but not yet actually off of it yet. And then it'll fall behind me. Then I'll log roll backwards, I'll go back onto that little cliff, and then I'll be able to walk onto it, climb on there, climb down the ladder, and then do everything like I did before. So that's great. That's the overall puzzle. Now I just have to solve the miniature puzzle of how do I get this thing onto my head. Which ought to be easy because I was just talking about it, but apparently it's not. Yeah, that's it. Okay. I knew there had to be some way to get everything here to work, and, indeed it does. There was a way. I was just thinking, like, hey, I need to manipulate the height of all my stuff. Help a guy out, would you? And, you know, the trees were, like, when I knew how to phrase my question the correct way, the trees were all too eager to oblige. Alright, so I found the fool's solution, the fool's way of doing it. But now I have found the truly wise way of solving Apex. So the greedy man will go ahead and eat two sausages, but the wise man will eat one now and save one for another time. Alright, that's the stuff. Alright, well, as usual, I think I'm gonna read the plinth and react to that. Hopefully in a positive way that like, affirms life in some manner and optimism. We'll see, though. And then I guess we'll call it quits. I'm watching you, game, but I'm listening.